I lost my childhood photos, many of them, so I think that's part of what's propelled me to create this piece. Hello, my name's Ntare Guma Mbaho Mwine, and 22 years ago, my car broke down in the small town of Mbirizi. I stumbled upon Kibaate Aloysius Ssalongo's photo studio, and from then, I went on a 22-year odyssey to document his story, his life, his images, and the thousands of people he photographed. Oh my God, when I first discovered Kibaate's work, my breath was taken away. I'd never seen a rural photographer documented thousands and thousands of people's lives. Before Kibaate passed away, I made a promise to him that I would exhibit his work and try to share it around the world, because his work took my breath away.
You take some really wonderful portraits. This one is great.
Yes.
And so there's one image in particular that I found really haunting of a wedding couple. And the bride is dressed in this incredible gown. You can see her clearer than the husband. And the groom, you only see one eye. And it's like he's still saying, I'm here. I had 5 decades of Kibaate's work and presented a large-scale outdoor exhibit, the first exhibit of his kind, in his village. People came from miles and discovered photographs that they didn't even know existed. Some that had been lost and they didn't think they would ever see again. People seeing family members who they'd never seen in person. In the thousands of photographs that Kibaate took, there's a large series of images of same-sex friendships or same-sex couples. We might never know what the story was behind those, because many of those people had passed. But one of the key things in these photographs was love and affection and intimacy. But when the Uganda government passed this anti-gay bill, I thought this would be an opportunity to explore these photographs. In the old days, you could hold hands with your friend and there was no issue. But now with this passing of this bill, people are afraid to just hold hands. I have been completely taken by surprise at the response to the film. In 3 weeks, the film has premiered on 3 continents and won 2 Best Documentary Feature Awards. He would be very proud to know that the promise is being kept and that we're continuing to get his work out and share his incredible photographs with the world. I think this story is a global story, because in the old days, photographs were kept in albums, shoeboxes, paper bags, and some of those photos are still there. So if you're one of those people whose family members still have those old boxes, go through them, find them.